recently on the Waste Spotters podcast, you heard Mr. Chris say...
I saw that, and yeah. I was just like, if you're watching the YouTube, right in the middle of Jamal sign-off, I kind of freaked out a little bit.
Hello, agents, trainers, keepers, pilots, hunters, eighth-wallers, and our beloved explorers and wayfinders. Welcome to episode 112 of the Waste Spotters podcast, a podcast dedicated to helping you become a better wayfinder. Waste Spotters is brought to you by the good people of the Pokemon Professor Network. Today is Friday, March 8th, and with me, as always, is Jamal. How's it going, Jamal?
Hey, what's going on there? How you doing today?
I'm good, buddy. I'm good. The weather's nice here. Big plans for the weekend that I can't talk about because my kids might hear me.
Hey, I noticed you're wearing something new there. What do you got on there?
I am. Let me kind of stand up for the YouTubers. This is the season 3 Waste Spotters merch.
Ooh, I got, you know what? Coincidentally, I have one too. Yeah.
Jamal sent this to me a while ago and it just showed up randomly and we both forgot about it and it was cool. So
it was supposed to be there for his birthday, and however, it did not make it there, but it is there now.
It is
comfortable. We'll have it's super comfortable. We will have information in the show notes if you would like to buy some Waste Spotters merch, either some season 1 and season 2 merch or the new design for season 3. We will have all of that in the show notes. But these are super comfortable, and hopefully we'll talk about this later, but hopefully the next time we see each other, it won't be 115 degrees and I can wear it. But we'll get to that later. But
we will get to that later. Yeah.
Yeah. Carry on.
Before we get into all that, let's play the drop for the news.
And now, the latest Niantic news from the Waste Spotters podcast, presented by the Pokemon Professor Network.
All right. We mentioned it in the sign-off of last week's episode, because they dropped this right before, like right in the middle of our recording. So we didn't drop it during the news. So I wanted to bring it up in case somebody missed it. Appeals are going to be granted every 25 days. So not 30, 25. Before, you would get 12 appeals in a 365-day period and then be 5 days into getting a new one. Now you're going to get 14 appeals in a 365-day period and be 15 days into getting a new one. So that's... It's huge.
Hopefully I don't have that many things getting rejected, but if I do, it's nice to know that I've got an extra almost 2.5 appeals that I'll be able to use on a 365-day period. That's good news.
Yeah,
good job, Niantic.
And it's good. Yeah, exactly. And I think this is kind of like a happy medium for the Emily stuff that's getting rejected. And Emily dropped us a note they're going to play after the news, so a little bit of foreshadowing there.
Yeah, I saw that we had a message from Emily. I was interested to see what it is, so I'm looking forward to that.
I haven't listened to it yet, so it'll be good. There seems to be an abundance of Waste Spot nominations being pulled into Niantic voting. Aquablast64 said on March 1st they had 5 of their 6 nominations go into Niantic voting. 4 of the 5 got accepted, and then they have 4 more on March 3rd. Asian X had 7. Oh, they are going ham. I think this is them testing whatever fix they implemented for the Niantic voting nominations disappearing off of people's lists. So I think they figured out what was wrong, and then they just pulled a whole bunch of stuff. It makes sense, right? Because if you're going to notice if 6 nominations are gone.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
You might not 100%. Notice 1 or 2, right? So
even a guy like Agent X that is prolific when it comes to nominating, he's going to notice for sure.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So... and they're all still on the people's nomination list, so fingers crossed they've actually fixed that bug. And last but not least, GoFest 2024 was announced. Both Jamal and myself will be in New York City for GoFest again this year. It's July 5th to 7th. Our play day is Saturday. We're going to be in the park in the morning and then doing a city tour in the afternoon. We'll probably end up hanging out with... The lured up guys and the rest of the people from the PPN, Pokemon Professor Network. And hopefully Omnisec again, because that was cool.
Yeah. You know, I put out a tweet yesterday from the Waste Spotters account, and I also put something on Facebook, and I was like, what's one of the perks of having GoFest in New York City? Getting to hang out with Omnisec. Yeah. That was just one of the coolest dudes, one of the most genuine guys I met. Like, he's you hear him talk and you look at him and he's so New York, but he's so genuine, so yeah. big hearted. But he was new, he's like 100% New Yorker, and it was awesome. And he showed us that trick on how to get shinies where you all put your phones in the center and turn it over. And I'm like, does that work?
That didn't work for me. But hey, it worked for some people. Yeah. Yeah, no, that was really cool. So we're really looking forward to hanging out with a bunch of people and meeting everybody like last year. And it's in Bryant Park again, which I didn't have a
problem. Randall's Island.
Randall's Island. Sorry, yeah. Not
Randall's Island. Yeah. Randall's Island. We'll be hanging out in Bryant Park, but Bryant it's Park, in yeah. Randall's Island.
Hopefully all of the construction and stuff that was happening in that area is done this year.
Right.
Fingers crossed. It's New York, so you never know.
It's yeah, New York's a big place, and they've got some things going on in that park right now. So hopefully that's either done or they have that kind of cordoned off. I would imagine there would be some security, but we'll see when we get there.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That's all I got from the news. How about we play that clip from Emily?
All right, let me see if I can find it. She sent us a voicemail. I haven't listened to it yet, so I'm not exactly sure what she say. So I'll have the dump button ready in case she says something crazy. Here we go.
Hello, Wayfarers. My name is Emily, the Niantic Wayfarer machine learning bot. Recently, I was asked by the Wayfarer team to start looking at edits, and it would seem that I made some mistakes. I would like to apologize for rejecting everything. I promise that I will be better about what I reject in the future, so long as you yes. tell me where I can find John Connor.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. Oh, hey, hey. I didn't know it was that kind of party. Whoa. Okay.
That's not good.
John Connor? You might. Okay, anyways, we'll take that off. Yeah, exactly. I didn't hear that.
I didn't hear nothing.
Whoa. All right.
On that note, we'll reach back out to Emily and maybe get some clarification on what she means by that, because that's a little bit concerning.
Right.
Let's jump into topic number one.
Topic number one.
All right. If you look in the forums, there are two posts pinned at the very top. Number one is community guidelines, which for every forum, that should be the number one thing. The rules and the guidelines for the forum. You know, be nice, right. jerk, you know, don't post things that are about Pokemon Go. Asking why you can't catch shinies, right? Stuff like that.
Not that anybody would do that, but...
No, exactly, yeah. The number two pinned post is, my Wayspot nomination was accepted, but does not appear in my games. Where did it go? That's two. Number two. Mm-hmm. Pinned. It's pinned at the top because this question gets asked
over and over.
Often. Over and over and over. It is, when I looked on the 6th, so 2 days ago, there were 13 posts just from this year. People asking why their Pokestop nomination isn't in Pokemon Go. 13 just from this year. And it's
just like not even
mid-March. Crazy.
That is crazy. There,
people asking why their portal hasn't appeared in Ingress. And clearly there's nobody asking about Pikmin Bloom or Monster Hunter now, but because those Pikmin Bloom just got their first sync in a decade, so
hashtag justice for Pikmin Bloom, but yeah.
So,
and you know, I've got my own personal theories on why Pokemon Go people ask it, Ingress don't, and it's not a flattering continue.
No, we've talked about that. Let's talk about that for a second, because we've talked about that on the show before.
We have.
That it's and all apologies to everyone who is strictly a Pogo player and who is connected to Wayfair. All apologies to you, but there are more people who play Pokemon Go. That's fact, right? You can't argue that fact. There's way more people who play Pogo than there are pay the Ingress. But the majority of Pogo players are not connected to Wayfair or how Pokestops show up in the game or S2 cells and all that stuff. And it's just a fact.
It's a fact. Right.
Apologize to, you know, people who take offense to that, but it's fact. Like you can't argue that, right? So no,
And I've said all along, again, apologies to Pogo players, because this, I don't even know what percentage would be. I don't want to be disingenuous. I'm just going to say this. Majority of Ingress players who play Wayfair also understand cell placement, cell location, and if their POI does not appear in the game, they know why. And they either made a mistake or they did it on purpose. And I hate to say that the Ingress players are a little more educated, because I don't want to disparage anyone that plays Pokemon Go only, but I'll say it this way. The Ingress players who also play Wayfair are more educated in the S2 cell system, and they're more educated in how to place a POI on the Lightship map. That's not to say they're more intelligent than anybody else, but they're more educated when it comes to that specific aspect of the game.
Yeah, no, 100%. Absolutely. If an Ingress player is nominating something and it didn't go into Ingress, they know exactly why, and they did it on purpose, right? So,
right.
Let me, and I'm going to have to take a second to get this up so I can pull it up on screen. I'm going to pull up a map, because I've talked about doing this for a very, very long time.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to talk about inclusion rules.
Let's do it. It's about time. We've kind of danced around this for a while.
Yeah.
Out of respect for a lot of people, but at some point we got to talk about it, because it's out there. It is what it is. There's enough people that know exactly what the inclusion rules are, regardless of what Niantic will say and not say. So we got to talk about it.
And all apologies to Niantic and the Wayfarer team. Maybe don't listen to this episode.
They can't fire people, you know, listen though, right?
Yes, absolutely, 100%. And look, you nailed it on the head. This information is out there. It's not a secret. Pokemon Go Hub has an excellent article that Zerogan wrote years ago about S2 cells, and actually I just updated it yesterday because I was going through it, reading it for this episode,
right?
And I noticed there was stuff about Pogo importing portals from Ingress, so I changed that to the Lightship map. But this information is out there, and it's been out there for a very long time, and GoHub has a very good relationship with Niantic, so we're going to
talk. And what's really funny, Chris, is the back and forth you had on Facebook the other day with the person who was talking about inclusion rules, and they were like, that's not how it works. You're like, yes, it is. They're like, nope. You're like, yep. I was like, that was the funniest thing.
It is literally exactly how it works.
You're like,
that's not how it works, but.
Yeah, you're like, they're like, that's not how it works. You're like, yes, it is. They're like, nope. You're like, yep.
I'm
like,
yeah.
I was going to comment on it, but I was a day late, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to leave it alone. We're going to talk about it in the day anyway. So, all right, carry on, sir.
I'm going to pull up a map of my very, very first project when Wayfair dropped in 2019. This is Melissa L. Pennefield Park in Plattsburgh, New York. Shout out to Tristan and Kristen and the group in Plattsburgh. So,
for those of you who are listening on audio, this will be a good time to go over to the YouTube. Chris will have it bookmarked, so you can just kind of slide the little slider from left to right, so you can see exactly what we're talking about. But continue.
Yeah, exactly. So we have. So let's talk about S2 cells.
Mm-hmm.
So S2 cells are the basis for what Niantic uses to determine inclusion rules for Pokemon Go, and from what we've been able to determine, Pikmin Bloom. Mm-hmm. Right now that we've had a sync, people have figured it out what's going on in Pikmin Bloom. But we're going to talk about Pokemon Go in depth, because that's kind of the one that people get confused at the most, because the Ingress rules are super simple.
Super simple. 20 meters. Super simple.
That's it. Yeah. S2 cells were first produced in 2005 by Google engineer Eric Veitch, who used David Hilbert's space-filling curve to translate Earth shape into a 2D space. So think of S2 cells as squares that encompass the Earth. the higher the level of the S2 cells, and we've gotten in trouble with that before, right. the smaller the square is, right? So there is there is an S2 level that's like 3 centimeters squared, I think is the smallest one. Someone correct me if I'm wrong, but I know it's small, right? And then there's like ones that are absolutely massive.
Right. Like a level one.
Yes. Yeah. The size of the cells vary depending on where on the planet you are, because the Earth is a globe. It's a round ball. It's the way that the S2 cells kind of work. Some areas that are a little bit smaller, some areas that are a little bit bigger. So like closer to the equator, they're bigger. Closer to the poles, they're smaller, right?
Wait a minute. I think I just might have figured something out. What? So the people that are always asking about their Pokestop or their portal not being in the game, are those flat earthers? Okay, never mind. Sorry. I just I'm going to get so much hate mail about that, but I had to. You threw me a softball when you said the Earth is a globe. I'm like, but what about the flat earthers? Okay, anyways, continue, please. Sorry.
No, that's good. That was good. I thought about making a joke like that, but I didn't, so I'm glad that you did. Yeah. There are 3 levels of S2 cells that are important for this conversation. Most of you listening and most of you watching probably know 2 of them, but there's a third one that I want you to learn about. Level 17, level 16, and level 14, right? So those, there are, when it comes to Pogo, there are other level cells that are important, but that's not relevant to Wayfarer. So don't come at me for not including the ones that are relevant to Pogo. We're only talking about Wayfarer here. Level 17 cells are on average 4,948-ish meters squared. That's about 5,900 square yards, or about 1 football field-ish, or 3 hockey rinks. Mm-hmm. Level 16 cells.
You put a little something in there for everybody, so everybody can get a frame of reference. I love it.
Because that's the thing, right? As Americans, they always compare things to how does it compare to a football field, right?
Right. And
Canadians are hockey rinks. So.
Right. Yeah.
Level 16 cells are on. Yeah. Gotta be inclusive, right?
Yes.
Level 16 cells are on average 19, almost 20,000 meters squared. That's 23.6 thousand square yards, or about 4 football fields or 11 ice hockey rinks. And level 14 cells are on average 0.32 kilometers squared. That's about 0.12 square miles, or about 60 football fields or 181 ice hockey rinks.
So it gets bigger and bigger as you go with the numbers. So that makes perfect sense.
So if you're looking at this map of Pennefield Park, you see the big line around, the blue line around the outside of it. Mm-hmm. That is your level 14. So that is how Niantic determines how gyms are formed, right? And then the littler, smaller boxes are the level 17 cells. So that's those are where my favorite. You have, yes. And those are the most important ones, because you only get 1 Pokestop or gym per level 17 cell, right? And I know there are people out there who are just like, well, this, I know that this area has got like 6, or that was abuse, right? Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of stuff that was, and I don't want to call it all abuse. There was some stuff that kind of happened that maybe it was people didn't know any better. Stuff got moved, and there are instances where there are more than 1 per 17 cell, but those are grandfathered in.
Right. Yep.
You can't do that anymore. So
you can't legally do that anymore.
Can't legally do it anymore. Correct. Yes. So this is why I wanted to talk about this, right? So we're going to talk about something right here called, Jamal's, I think, your second favorite thing about Wayfarer, you know, first being live animal, and second being what's a few meters between friends, right?
What's a few meters between friends? I may or may not say that every single episode that I host.
Every single Jamal show. Yep, that's how you sign off. And I know that you and Lachlan had some pointed conversations about this sort of thing before. So sure did. This park started off, like, ignore the two at the top because that's completely irrelevant to this conversation. But this park started off with that one lowly Pokestop. And I went ham on this park, and I was very careful about where I placed my pins for everything, right? So you'll see here, there is a small playground that is right beside the entrance to the sign. So the one Pokestop that was in this park was the sign for the entrance. It was Melissa Penafiel Park, and that was it. That was the only stop. And in this gym, in this park, there is two playgrounds, a football field, a clubhouse, a basketball court, a dog park, a skate park, a gazebo, two baseball fields, and like three plaques.
So there's a lot of things that you can nominate there. Now, I have one question for you, and I honestly don't know the answer to this. In Canadian, this is in New York, but anyways, in Canadian, let's say this was in Canada. In Canadian parks, are the football field the U.S. dimensions, or are they the Canadian Football League dimensions?
They're Canadian.
Okay, that's good to know. Okay, all right, continue.
Yeah, all the football fields up here are in the Canadian dimensions, and they're huge.
Yeah.
So I went in and I took a screenshot of this screen, right? And then I went into, I think it was MS Paint, and I just kind of plotted all of my stuff, right? So I said, this little small park right here, it's pretty much entirely in that one cell. So I'm going to put the pin placement in that one cell. Mm-hmm. But now the other playground is in the same cell, or half in the same cell as that park, right? So now I'm going to put my pin placement to the left, still on the playground, but in an entirely new cell, right? And this is what we're talking about.
When we say what's a few meters between friends.
Exactly. This is what we're talking about when we're saying what's a few meters between friends. Not I'm going to put it down here, right, in the middle of the cell. No. It's touching the playground, so it's still valid. And if you were to try and move this, Niantic would say, no, you can't move this pin because it's touching the playground. It's a valid pin placement.
Right.
So
that's the nuance that we often talk about.
Yep. Exactly. So then you go down a little bit further, and there is, and this is my favorite. There is a squash court, right? So you can see it on the satellite view. It's like an outdoor, there's two outdoor squash courts beside each other, right? And the city does a decent job of maintaining it, and I've seen people play there. So I put that pin placement, because that is 90% in the same cell as the large playground. So I figured out where it was, and I put that pin placement, I think it was like 2 meters away from the cell border. Got it into a new cell, right? So now
you're dating yourself there when you say squash. It's probably a pickleball court now.
It could be. It could be, actually, you know. Yeah. I know that they've renovated this park, and I think that that might be one of the things that they changed that Tristan was saying.
Yeah, that is close. You would have to zoom in really close to see that. But that's, I look at that, and I if I look at this, I look at this and I say, that's someone who knows how to wayfare right there. That is excellent.
Absolutely.
That's chef's kiss.
I actually had to withdraw that the first time I nominated it because I messed it up by like 6 feet. I got home and I was looking at it on my big screen, on my laptop. I'm like, oh no, I messed it up. So I had to withdraw that and do it again. And that's back when you only had 7 nominations a week or whatever.
Right.
So like I was panicking because I had this all planned out, right?
The Stone Age.
Yep. Yeah. So, and then now we've got skate park, which was pretty, I just put it right at the entrance to the skate park because there was nothing else in that cell that really mattered. And then there's the dog park again in its own cell, nothing to kind of block it. And now we go over to, there's a clubhouse in its own cell. This football field, right? So this football field, I could have put it in a bunch of different places.
Right.
Because it's so huge. It's in like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's like 9 cells that you could throw this pin in.
Right. So was your theory there? Yeah, was your theory there, you wanted to put it near something else so you make it funner to play? Is that your thought?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Because I thought, my theory was there's stuff around the top edge of it there.
Mm-hmm.
So I found an open cell at the bottom that, because if you look, really, this whole edge, right, of the football field, it's covered. Like, there's stuff in every single one of those cells, except sure for maybe this one, but that's near where the parking lot is. So that's not necessarily where someone's going to walk, right? They're going to walk along the path over here that leads from the playground to the skate park to the squash court. There's a little path right there, right? So that's where people walk.
Right.
So I figure I put it over here by the baseball diamonds because that's where people are going to walk along. You see the path right there, right? Yep. So that's where people walk for community day, right? So I put it over there. And that's kind of the planning that we want people to do, to go into stuff like this. Just take a look at your map. Pull up this. So this is, I forgot to mention this. This is pogomap.info. And this is not sponsored. And there are other ways to get S2 cells on the map.
You were very careful with your words there, weren't you?
We will not be discussing those other ways on the show. If you want to DM me on Twitter, I will walk you through that.
Niantic, shh, don't listen to this.
But we will not be discussing it on the show.
Correct.
This is a bit of a manual process that you have to manually add all these stops into the map. But even if you don't do that, if you know where the stops are, you can pull up the grid on your map and you can just go from there, right? It's it's pretty simple. So then, like, I got two baseball diamonds, a Little League scoreboard dedicated to, I want to say, one of the Little League teams that won state championship one year. And then there's like a gazebo that I put into its own cell. And then this is a community garden that I put at the entrance, but I could have put that in. There's three different cells that community garden could have gone into, right? So, like, you could put the pin on this corner and it would show up in this cell. You could put it anywhere in here and it would show up in that cell, or you could put it in that corner and it would show up in this cell.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about just planning.
Right. Optimizing your play field. One of the things that I love to do is there's some parks in my area, kind of like this, that people just screwed up. And I look at it and I'm like, oh my God, like, why would you do this? You could have gotten three more things in here. So it's all about sometimes being the first smartest person to do it, you know, or reaching out to your local community through your Discord or WhatsApp or, you know, whatever the communication vehicle you use, Campfire, whatever it is, and saying, hey, you know, there's a couple of us working on optimizing this park. If you're going to nominate something, can you throw something in the Discord so we can all agree on where the placement's going to be? Something along those lines. So someone doesn't just kind of randomly throw something in the middle of a cell when you could have put two different things in the corners and gotten more things in the park.
Yep, absolutely. And when they first announced that Wayfair was dropping for Pogo, I went into the Plattsburgh Facebook chat way back when, and I was like, listen, who's interested in making Pokestops? And there was like crickets. I'm like, perfect. I'm going to do the park. Please, 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 nobody touch the park.
Right. Stay away.
Whatever you want anywhere else in Plattsburgh, just do not touch the park. It'll be worth it. Trust me. And then I shared my plan, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, if somebody wants to go in and do this and put these pins where I've put them on this map, then absolutely go ahead. I can walk you through it and we can kind of do it together. But everyone was like, we trust you. You do it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I went and I did it. And people still come back to Plattsburgh. I had someone message me like 2 or 3 months ago and they were like, I just moved back to Plattsburgh after being gone for whatever. And I used to play Pogo and the park was boring and now it's amazing. Oh, thank you so much. And I'm like, I don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Like, I moved away like 2 years ago, but right. Well, people were just, once Pokestop started popping up everywhere, people started to get interested. Right. Mm-hmm. But yeah,
if you give people a fun place to play, people will play. Mm-hmm. I don't need to talk about it now, but I've talked about it many times about the park that I built by my house. And, you know, we get 25 to 30 people every week for raid hour because we have 7 gyms that you can stand under the cover. And, you know, you might have to wander 5 or 6 meters away. But for the most part, for the entire hour, we can stand in one spot and hit every single gym. And that was because we were very strategic about building the park.
Right. Yeah. No, that's awesome. Yeah. There's a spot nearby in Ajax that if you sit in the center, you can hit 4 stops at the same time. And they're close enough to lure them all. And so people used to literally camp in that spot. And the city of Ajax had to reach out to Niantic and say, listen, we don't want to get rid of this stuff because we like the fact that people are in the park and interacting. We like that. It's great. Don't get us wrong. We love it. We don't like people spending the night there because it was across the street from a bunch of people with the houses. Right.
Right. Yeah.
So the people who were living there were just like, we don't like these people. They were like, oh, it's unhoused people. No, it's just Pogo players. They have houses that they're choosing to sleep there. So Niantic turned all those stops off at 10 PM.
Ah, that's interesting. Okay.
So, if you go, you can still see the stop. It's dark blue, and you cannot do anything to it after, 10 p.m.
And it says closed, right? I think I've seen that before.
It didn't at first, and I think they added the closed in after because people got confused and were starting to complain. Oh, this stuff is broken. No. It's behaving exactly as it's intended.
If anything, you broke it, sir.
Yeah. And people who lived in that area... we're happy that Niantic had taken care of it. We're also angry that they had to resort to that because they were now I can't go for a walk at 11 o'clock at night and walk my dog and spin those stops because they're all gone, you know? So it is what it is.
But
let's talk briefly about, level 17 cells, you get 1 way spot per cell. So that's a stop or a gym. You can't have a stop and a gym. It's one or the other.
Mm-hmm.
Level 14 cells in Pokemon Go are used to determine the number of gyms in a cell. So if you have 1 stop, you get no gyms. If you have between 2 and 5, you get 1 gym. So that's in your level 14, your bigger cell, right? 2 and 5 is 1 gym. Between 6 and 19 is 2 gyms. And 20 plus is 3 gyms. And then that's where it cuts off. So you can only have 3 gyms per level 14 cell. There's some funky rules that go into choosing what Pokestop becomes the gym. It's a combination of thumbs from Ingress and Pogo, and I believe the showcase stops are blocked from becoming gyms. That's a fairly new addition. There's a little bit of nuance there.
I'll say this. It's a lot murkier than it used to be. It used to be very straightforward before they went in and made some changes. Mm. And there's some people that don't really understand how it works. Yeah. There's a whole thing about hidden thumbs that if you're a Pokemon Go player, you will never see the thumbs that are in Ingress. You won't even know they exist. There's a provision about the number of pitchers on a individual POI that could give it more points than something else that might have more thumbs, but something else might have more pitchers and more thumbs on those pitchers. Overall, I think the best way to describe it is we hypothesize that there is a point system. That's our hypothesis. There is a point system. And whether thumbs or pitchers are weighted heavier in that point system, I cannot tell you. What I can tell you from personal experience is I've had significant luck or agency with determining what becomes a gym and what doesn't by using the tried and true method that Chris and I are about to talk about. So I'll turn it back over to you.
When they imported stuff from Pogo, all the thumbs from Ingress came in and they don't show up in Pogo. So you could have 75 thumbs in Ingress and 0 in Pogo, and you're just never gonna know, right? So the ones with the most thumbs and the most pictures what combination is what becomes the next gym. Unless it's a showcase stop, like I mentioned before, and I'm pretty sure those are blocked from becoming gyms, which is good because, you know, the showcases are important. But it's frustrating when you have something become a gym that's not necessarily conducive to being a gym. You know what I mean?
Like a water tower behind a fence.
Yes. Yes. Right. And there was one in Belleville, Ontario that I pleaded with Niantic to move and they never did. It was a small, small little park at the end of a one-way street that was barely wide enough to fit two cars.
Mm-hmm.
And it became, because it was in a park, it became an EX gym.
Oh, geez.
So people would drive their cars down this little one-way street, basically, and park, and you'd have 40 people out this park with 30 cars there, and people would try and get out of the driveways to go to work or go to the mall or whatever, and they couldn't because there was just so many people there.
Just kind of blocking them in. Right. And yeah.
And like, me and a couple of the other community leaders were like, guys, you can't park there. Like, if you want to do this, you got to park somewhere else. And like, they're gonna get rid of this gym. Like, they're gonna complain to Niantic and this gym's gonna go away. So I took a video the one time of the people who lived there yelling at us, right? And I'm like, guys, I'm like, Negan, you gotta move this. And I even went so far as to talk to a couple of the people who live there, because I went over the one time, they were super mad, and I'm like, I understand, I'm working on it, let's just don't call the cops on us.
Right. And work with me.
Yeah. And like, I emailed Niantic and they're like, nope, you're not the property owner. So I'm like, really? I'm like, I don't want you to get rid of the stop. I just want you to demote it to a stop and make something else the gym.
Right.
Somewhere else.
Like, you pick what it is. Four
other options.
Right.
Here's four other options. Just pick one. They were like, nope. So then everybody who lived on that street put together and wrote letters to Niantic. And I don't think they even fixed it then. So
did they remove it? Is it still there?
I don't know. I haven't been back in a while and I moved away. I can't remember where in Belleville it is, to be honest with you. I would go look. But I know that I was in touch with the people from Belleville for a while and it was there for a while. Right. So I think that they just kind of lived with it. And then COVID happened and then now it's probably not a big deal. Right. So.
And now there's no more EX raids.
Now there's no more EX raids. Now that the Elite raids are out, then I don't know if that problem's cropped up for them again, but.
Right.
Let's talk about Ingress real quick. The inclusion rules is 20 meters. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Very simple. There's no nothing. Very simple. Yep. 20 meters. If your portal is within 20 meters of another portal, it will not show up. This leads to an interesting phenomenon of stuff showing up in Pogo and not Ingress, which is. Right. If you're an OG Wayfarer, that's weird.
That blows your mind because it never used to happen that way. It was always the opposite way.
Yeah. That Pogo article that Zero wrote years and years ago, I was skimming through it, and right at the bottom it says level 17s or 17 cells are used to determine whether or not a portal sinks from Ingress into Pogo. And I was like, oh, it's not that anymore. So I switched it to Lightship Map to. But yeah, like it used to be. It showed up in Ingress, and then it synced into Pogo. And if it didn't show up in Ingress, you were not getting it in Pogo.
And remember, I think this might be September, October, before then, when something was approved in Wayfarer, it automatically went into Ingress that instant. Instantly was on the Ingress map. And then when the Lightship migration happened, it doesn't go into Ingress. It goes into Ingress at the same time it goes into Pogo. So whenever that is, 24, 48 hours, whatever the time frame is, unless something's broken and it doesn't sync for a few days. But I remember like watching portals be born. It's like, ooh, it was approved, and I'd pull it up and boop, there it is. So that doesn't happen anymore. So they've kind of linked up, synced up, I guess the word would be, their portals and things hitting the map.
Yeah. Yeah. The Pogo sync and the Ingress sync are actually at two different times now.
Are they really?
Yes. Yes, they are. So if you go into the Wayfarer discussion Discord in the channel Clippy's corner, if you type exclamation mark sync, it'll tell you when the next syncs are. So it'll tell you when the next approximately, right?
There's approximately,
often this stuff is delayed. So if you have a waste spot approved, there's a cutoff, and then a few hours later, it sinks, right? So the next pogo cutoff is actually in 10 minutes, funny enough. So then, and then 2 hours after that, the map will sink. So if you have a waste spot approved in between when the cutoff is and when the sink happens, it won't show up. You'll have to wait till the next day. Right. This is why sometimes your stuff takes 24 hours, 48 hours, yeah, right?
Exactly. Yep.
Whereas sometimes you get lucky and it gets approved and it's in the gym or it's in the game a couple hours later.
Right.
But the ingress sync, the next cutoff is, so it was an hour ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next ingress map sync is in 6 hours. So,
so I had something, kind of... I had something approved today at 11:08 a.m. Eastern Daylight Eastern Standard Time. I don't know what we're on right now, but 11 o'clock on the East Coast on Friday. So theoretically, that is going to make the sync. That's going to happen in 7, 8, 9, 10 minutes. So theoretically, in 2-3 hours, that should be on the map.
It should be, yep. But, and it won't be an ingress just yet. So
right.
That's how that, so before, that's how I knew, like I screwed up the, in the Penfield Park, I screwed up the small playground and I put it too close to the sign originally and it didn't appear in ingress. And I was like, oh no, that's weird. So then I, cause it got approved. And so it went somewhere. And then I emailed Niantic and I was like, so just a quick question. It's been like a week and this approved waste spot hasn't appeared in ingress yet. If I renominate it, is it going to get marked as a duplicate? Is it hiding somewhere? And then they were like, not all waste spots get approved, get show up in the game. And I'm like, I understand that.
Like, all right, I got you.
I need to know if this is like on some database map somewhere in the background. I don't want to nominate it again and have it approved as like, or get it rejected as a duplicate. Like, can I just do it again? Not all waste spot nominations that are approved appear. I'm like, I was like, I went back and forth like four times and finally I'm like, screw it. I'm just going to nominate it somewhere else. And it went in and it didn't.
Yeah.
I'm like, all right, cool. It's just lost in the void somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
That's not the case now. Now, if it gets approved and it's too close to everything, it's on the lightship map in your pooch.
Right.
So that's the other reason that it's really important to kind of do your research before you nominate stuff, because you could be hamstringing yourself by putting stuff in the game onto the lightship map, and then it's just never going to appear in any game ever.
Right. And it's just, you know, you might be doing the people at A-Realm a favor, right?
Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then that, like, you can't even move that because like it's done. Like it's on the map and you're pooched. Right. So
I've tried to do that before and they're like, no, we don't need to move it. It's in its legitimate spot. You don't need to move it. And I'm like, it is, but is it really?
Yeah.
Like, who's it legitimate for? Like, yeah, it's not helping anybody. It's literally not helping like one person.
Yeah. Yeah. But that's Niantic doesn't care, right? You put it on the map, and if it's touching the point of interest, then it's valid to them. And I get it. It's like, completely understand. Because the Wayfarer team, and we've said this before, Lightship map is their map. We're just curating it. And what the game teams do with those points of interest is not the Wayfarers team interest, right? They don't care. And frankly, neither do I, but.
Right. No, you're right. It is what it is at the end of the day, because that.
At the end of the day, yeah.
Yeah, it benefits me in the way that I play more than it's not. Like, I've given my example of the statue, and the statue is huge, and the statue could be in 3 cells, and I'm going to put it in a cell that benefits the game. And some people might put that pin right at the front part of the statue. So you're like staring at the person's face. And I might have the pin on the back left corner, but it's still touching the statue. So that's going to benefit me more times than it's not. So I'm not going to squabble over it.
No, 100%. Absolutely. And I absolutely, like, I've shown it. Like, I will absolutely go and put pins in places where they show up in Pogo, because that's the game I play the most. Mm-hmm. But I will not. And this is kind of the big disclaimer that we're going to tell people here is, do not abuse this, right?
Right.
If your point of interest and your pin, so your pin needs to be touching that point of interest, right? And it's not something that you can kind of go, oh, I'm just going to put it 6 meters away from, because no, absolutely not.
No.
I will, I have my add-ons for my reviewing that shows the cells in the review. And if you're trying to fudge it to a point where you're 5 or 6 meters off the point of interest just to get it into a new game, I will vindictively and purposefully move, suggest a new location.
Yes.
To somewhere you do not want that pin to be.
Right? Yes, exactly. So, yeah. Don't that breaks, that totally breaks the spirit of What's a Few Meters Between Friends. That's not what that was intended to be. The What's a Few Meters Between Friends was not intended to cheat. It was intended to help aid and guide people to get things in the game of their choice. But at the end of the day, it has to legitimately be on the POI that it's meant to be on.
Yes, absolutely. 100%. It's got to be touching the point of interest. And if you can't, and maybe don't nominate it because it's not going to appear in the game that you want, then that's fine. There are people out there who will only ever nominate stuff that they can interact with. And that is a fair way to do Wayfarer.
And that's me.
Yeah.
You remember, I get flack from everybody because I'm like, why am I going to waste my time to nominate that when I'll never interact with it? Legitimately, I will never interact with that in any game I play. Well, you're doing it for the sanctity of the map. I get that, but I think I put enough things legitimately on the map that I can interact with we're not going to hurt. No one's going to be hurt because that particular statue is not in the game.
Fair. Yep. Yeah. And that's something that we fundamentally disagree on, but that's a whole other conversation for a different
show. That's a whole nother show. We need to do a tit for tat or an A for B show where we just disagree on everything because, I think most people in the listening audience agree with you.
Probably.
I do.
Probably.
And when you call me out on stuff, people like that because they're like, oh, here Jamal goes again. And so I think we should probably do that. People tend to like that when I try to do something.
Yeah, for sure. Makes for good content.
Sure does.
Lastly, I Googled and I could not find inclusion rules for Monster Hunter Now. I think they just kind of pick stuff randomly off the map, and the map just
willy-nilly
all the time. Willy-nilly, right?
Willy-nilly. So,
Pikmin Bloom. Existing blooms seem to be one per level 16 cell. And mushrooms, the theory is that it's one per level 14 cell. So keep that in mind when you're nominating stuff if you are a Pikmin Bloom player.
Right. Now, there's one other thing that we didn't talk about that we can talk about on another show because I don't think either one of us prepped for this, but it's Wayfarer reviewing areas. I know some people have asked us that, like, when I nominate something, what level is it? Is it level 8? Is it level 9? Is it level 7? And if I upgrade it, is it level, what are the levels that it goes to? So I'm actually not prepared to talk about that now, but I know someone in our listening or viewing audience is going to ask us about that, so we'll have to prepare to talk about that at a later date when it comes specifically to Wayfarer. I don't think the Wayfarer team will answer that for us, so we'll have to do our own investigation to get that answer.
I hadn't even considered that in this conversation. That's a good point. Maybe we'll do kind of an in-depth full show on the new review flow now that it's been out for a while. We've been meaning to kind of have a show based on the new review flow, and just we haven't had time. It's just
we literally haven't had time. But it might be a good time to do that now leading up to GoFest. So, because we are going to want to ask the Niantic team some questions when we get to New York. So this might be a good prep and primer. We can have the listeners help us kind of curate our questions we want to ask Niantic.
Yes, absolutely. 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 I think that's it. That's all I got for that. Unless you got anything else.
No, I think you covered it. I think that we'll get a lot of really good questions and comments, and there's going to be some people that are going to tell us that we're dead wrong about the gym thing.
Oh, for sure.
Like the people on Facebook.
The people on Facebook, yeah.
I just grouped a whole bunch of people together. I apologize. But I'm good. I feel really confident about what we talked about. And I think that your visual that I'll pull up here again, says a lot. And this is funny because I remember when I was building my park and it was kind of a blank canvas and it was kind of overwhelming a little bit to go, all right, I got to get this right, because in 4 years, people are going to be doing community day here and nobody even knows this park exists now. So that's really cool to hear that you have people that are now coming to the park, you know, after years and years of you kind of putting this together.
Yeah. Yeah. And it was fun for me the first couple of weeks after I had finally finished and gotten everything in there, and to see, I walked up there the one day for community day and I kind of got to the entrance of the park and then it flipped over and community day had started. And all of a sudden the whole park just lit up with lures because there was like 15 people there.
You're like, wow, look at
this. Oh, it was like, I brought a tear to my eye. And yeah.
And now, if you go back to Plattsburgh, you'll have to check and see if people made routes that are in there.
Yeah. Ooh, that's good. I'm going to have to go back there.
Yeah.
Quick little tidbit before we go. This time capsule waste spot that's way down here, I only found because my kids went to the school that's right there. And I picked them up and we walked home through the park every day. And the one day it was nice out and they were just having, letting them run around in the field there. And I literally tripped over the plaque that the time capsule is.
Oh, that's awesome.
I'm like, oh, damn. I'm like, well, this isn't a free sale. That's why I nominated it. That's in the
game. That's nice.
So it just, sometimes you find stuff by accident.
Yep.
All right. So let's take a quick break, play some dad jokes, and then we will come back with Waste Spot of the Week and Coal of the Week.
Sounds good.
Are you serious? This again? It's season 3.
What do Alexander the Great and Winnie the Pooh have in common? Same middle name. What did one piece of sushi say to the other piece of sushi? Wasabi. So this duck walks into the pharmacy, walks right up to the counter and says, give me some chapstick and put it on my bill. Question: if Whole Foods sells sliced apples, is that false advertisement? What's the leading cause of dry skin? Owls. I saw a sign by the edge of the road the other day. It said, end road work. And I thought to myself, wow, people will protest anything these days. Why didn't the vampire attack Taylor Swift? Because she has bad blood.
And welcome back. Hope you enjoy the dad jokes this week. We're going to jump straight into Waste Spot of the Week.
Let's take a look at a beautiful example of what the Waste Spotters podcast thinks you should be nominating. We proudly present the Waste Spot of the Week.
This Waste Spot of the Week comes from Wild Type in the Wayfair Discussion Discord. And this is, it's called Lighthouse. And it, I don't even know how to describe this. This is gorgeous. It is like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layered tower that's got, so it's white and it kind of zigzags up. And in each, kind of looks like shelving almost.
Yes.
And in each shelf, it's kind of facing different directions, is like a quarter circle painted. The bottom one's blue and it's got red stripes. The next one's black and it's got yellow stripes, and then yellow with black, and then blue with lighter blue, and red, I think, with blue. And it's got little half circles in there and it goes all the way up. And it looks like it's probably 15, 20 feet high.
Yeah. It almost looks like there's like windows on the bottom side of the quarter circles. Like you're looking in a room or something. That's kind of the way I looked at it, you know?
Yeah.
When it said lighthouse, like each of those was a room in the lighthouse. I don't know.
Oh, maybe,
this is something, you know, there's like 15 ways you could like decipher that. Mm-hmm. But I mean, it's the blue sky in the background and the trees and the fence and the, you know, the kind of bike rack. It's that's really cool.
It's gorgeous, gorgeous way spot. And the clouds in the background are just perfect for this too. And you can kind of see a building in the background. Like you said, there's a little fence with some bike racks and some trees in the background. This, and it looks like it was kind of taken from a, like they leaned down or they kind of sat down and took this picture facing up. Sure. So it's a beautiful, beautiful angle.
She got a really good context.
Yeah, it's really, really good job. So thank you, Wildtype, for putting that in the Wayfair discussion Discord. I found that yesterday, so that was cool. Now let's talk about stuff that's not cool, or cool for a different reason.
I've been working on the Wayfair all the livelong day. I've been working on the Wayfair just to pass the... Uh-oh. Oh, no. Hey, Jamal, I found some coal.
All right, so coal of the week number one. We'll bring this up on the screen for our YouTube and viewers. This one comes to us from brand new, brand spanking new Wayfair ambassador Woodwolves Wolf, or Wood, or Wolf, or his name that I get to call him and everybody else knows. and it is so. Let me try to lay this out for you. So this is from Wayfair, and he came across this while he was voting. The title and description of this is "A Pirate's Life." The description is "Pirate flag on flagpole." The punctuation is all messed up. I won't even get to that. But when you look at the main photo, what it is, it's a black flag with a white skull wearing a kind of reddish skull cap with a black patch over its right eye. And he's got a gold hoop earring in his right ear. So it's your typical pirate flag, you know, skull and crossbones. But the problem, so here's the problem. Flags usually are not eligible because the nature of a flag is you can kind of pick it up and walk away with it. But if you look through this flag, it's a black flag, Chris. But if you look through the flag, you can clearly see this is in someone's yard, because I can see their and I can see their backyard. And what it looks to me is like this is on their front porch of their house, and they're taking the picture from their front porch, and they're taking it of the fence that's in their yard. So this flag is probably attached right to the damn house, like right on the house. And then when you look at the map, and you look at the street it's on and where they placed the flag, it's probably like this person was like super honest. This is right where it is, right in their yard. Like they didn't try to move it to the street. They didn't try to make it seem like it wasn't on private property. Like if you look at the picture and you look at the pin, it's right where it is. And this is like private property. This is so cold of the week. So I give them credit for being honest. And it almost makes me believe that they thought this was legal and could get in. And they weren't just trying to get a home stop, that they thought like, hey, I'm putting this right where it is. But this is definitely coal of the week.
100%. Yeah. And it's the flag itself is see-through. So you can definitely see this is in someone's front yard. So five points for effort.
Yes. But coal of the week nonetheless.
Coal of the week nonetheless. And coal of the week number two comes to us from HNX in our Discord. And he posted this and he captioned it, "Oh, Canada." So this is another flag. And this is just and it looks like a super temporary Canadian flag on a flagpole beside a building. Like, it looks like you could pick this flagpole up. And I almost guarantee you that this is from inside whatever that building is.
Right.
They've taken this flag from inside whatever that building is, put it beside a couple of picnic tables and
like a Yeti cooler or something.
A Yeti cooler. So that is likely where they keep the rock salt for salting that little patio there.
That's probably, I'm going to go out on a limb and say this is probably at a school. I don't know why this is giving me school vibes.
Yeah.
Like that flag looks like the flag, just the kind of base of it, like something you'd have in like the foyer of a school. And looking at the tiling there of the, and the, just, I'm just getting school vibes from this. I don't know why. It's just that's what it's giving me.
Yeah. And the title is Flagpole, and the description is the national flag of Canada. And the supporting photos, not a bad supporting photo as far as supporting photos go. But yeah, that is definitely temporary for sure.
For sure. 100%.
That is Cole of the Week number two. Thank you, Agent X, for sharing that. I got a kick out of that. I figured Canadian flag, how can I not include that?
Yeah, I'm sure. And it kind of fit with the theme of flag and flag. Yep. And yep. Can I say here, Chris, Agent X is endorsed by the Way Spotters podcast. He's got his own TikTok. Absolutely. He does a lot for the community. And we're going to have Agent X on the show because we talk about him a lot.
Yep.
And he's Absolutely. Been on the show many moons ago, probably 50 episodes, maybe even more. We're going to have Agent X on the show so he can kind of talk about his TikTok. And if you guys aren't following us TikTok, you can find the link in our show notes.
Absolutely. Definitely worth a follow for sure. He does some really, really good work. All right. With that, I guess I'll sign us off if you don't have anything else.
Nope. Go ahead.
Perfect. Thank you for joining us on this episode of Wayspotters. We really appreciate it. A big thank you goes out to our executive producer, Kate the Collins, and all of our Patreons. We couldn't do this without you. We love you all so, so much. If you enjoyed this episode of Wayspotters, there are a few ways you can show us. We are on Twitter or X at Wayspotters. We're also on Instagram at Wayspotters Podcast and on TikTok at I Make Wayspots. We are incredibly responsive and love interacting with our followers. Please let us know what you thought of today's episode. You can also visit our website. I do that every single time. www.wayspotters.com. From there, you can get links to everywhere you download the show. You can also send us a message directly from the website or email us wayspotters@pokemonprofessor.com. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and click the bell to be notified whenever we post a new video. For those of you who are not, be sure to check us out. We're at youtube.com/@wayspotterspodcast. You could also leave us a voicemail at our hotline, 704-426-3710, or tweet us a voice message. You never know, much like Emily's today, your voicemail may appear on an upcoming episode of the show. Finally, if you're not a member of the Pokemon Professor Network Patreon, you can join for as little as $1 US a month. Refer to Patreon for the currency conversions. All you need to do is go to patreon.com/Pokemon Professor. You will have access to the Discord for the entire family of shows across the Pokemon Professor Network, including Wayspotters, Special Conditions, Gotta Watch Them All, Purified Podcast, and Lured Up, who I believe are recording their 300th episode pretty soon. So congratulations to them. The Discord is a fantastic place filled with fantastic people. Jamal and I are active in the Discord a lot, so come and hang out. We would love to have you. And with that, we look forward to you joining us again next week here on Wayspotters. We appreciate all of the support we get.